Okay, students. Now we are live streaming, yeah, on YouTube. Okay, let's start. So let's start this event, the public speaking event or performance from the students as a public speaker. Okay, it's my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to you all. Yes, your presence makes us very happy. Looking around, I can see many familiar faces of students. It's great to see you all here. And many of you have made huge effort to join us today in the public speaking performance. Wow. I'm deeply appreciative and offer you our most grateful welcome. Look at all those smiling faces here. Welcome everybody. Welcome for you all viewers and subscribers of this channel. It's with tremendous pleasure that I welcome you to our first public speaking performance. I decided to create this one-day event as a way to gather together every students here. And anyway, I can't express our gratitude enough. Thank you for your joining and show your best in this event. And today, there are 16 public speakers are preparing their performance in this event. Let me mention the name and also the topics. Adi Saputra, how the blind people use technology of it. And Nurhamisa, all about the flutes. Asmila Mustafa, the millennials' viewpoint related to marriage. Muhammad Asrullah Arifin, with the topic Be Yourself and Upgrading Our Quality. Sri Wahyuningsi, bullying and its bad side. Oh, interesting. Hardiansyah, self-belief. Muhammad Ainul Hilmi, the advantage of writing. Rosmala Dewi, online lectures during the pandemic COVID-19. Oh, this is the updated topic, I guess. Siti Hardianta Nasir, my goal is my process. Andi Firhamsyah about education in Indonesia. Nur Amalia is about COVID-19. Andi Rahmawati, cosmetic surgery risk. Okay, all the women should see this. Yeah, this is listen and see this topic. Santiani, the importance of education. Swana, smoking in the public. Ayu Chandrayani, woman emancipation. Ade Reski Amalia, how to handle the bullying. And okay, those are the 16 public speakers. But maybe during the process of public speaking performance, there will be the next students who will join in this event. So let's start this event with the first public speaker. Okay. So I would like to invite Adi Saputra to present your topic. Time is yours.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, guys. Okay. First of all, we would like to say thank you for our God, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, because He has give our chance so we can attend this event. And now I want to share to you about how to the blind people use a technology, especially a laptop. But before that, I say to you, a laptop, they use a blind people like a laptop generally, but for the blind people, we can install one of software. Its name is NVDA. NVDA is a non desktop visual accessible. It can use to the blind people. It can use it. It use for blind people to do our job is in the laptop. And now, in this case, I want to share to you how to save a document in laptop. First, we must open the Microsoft Word like this.
WORD Microsoft Word 2010 at a GNOME pane document Microsoft Word product activate.
And then
move in. Close.
After Microsoft Word open, we types our word some words like this.
Space A L W A Y S space O O L O V E I N G space Y O U space E V R Y space D A Y.
Like this.
I always loving you every day.
I always loving you every day. And now, if you want to save this document, we press Control plus S.
Save as dialog, file name, combo box collapse.
And then we give the name of the document, like this.
A-D-E. T-S-A-D-O-C-U-M-E-N-E. T-S.
Addis document is a name
top
of
eight documents.
It names of my document. And then we press enter.
Eight documents, not docs, Microsoft Word.
That's all way of how to save the document like this, like that.
Restore R, close text.
And now I want to share to you how to copy the document in add another folder like this.
Edit, shut up, start screen S.
We open the document.
Document have a one page with
in the document.
Land, document picture, document unknown, documents window.
And then
digital edition, eight documents, dot docs, row two, column one.
We search document yang kita simpan tadi,
Eight documents, dot docs, row two, column
and
one.
And then we press Control plus C.
Copy. Text.
And then we open this PC.
This PC window, items view list.
And then we press panel bawah.
Download music.
After
devices at local disk data D row 2 column 1 8 of 10.
Cari after mendapatkan data D sampai kita dapat data D.
Items view list.
And then press enter and press Control plus V.
Paste progress data D. Window items view list eight documents dot docs row 17.
Jadi panelnya sudah ada di bawah di pasti.
Two eight documents.
Okay, I think that's all for my presentation today. Thank you for your join. Don't forget like, share, and comment. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, it was the performance from Ade Saputra. As you know, Ade Saputra is one of the blind or has need a special service from our English education department, the blind students in our department. So the way he presented the public speaking performance, that's amazing. It was amazing. And now we would like to invite, yes, we would like to invite the next speaker. Is siapa lagi? Who's the next? Is the second number second Nur Khamisa. Are you ready, Nur Khamisa? Nur Khamisa.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nur Khamisa. That's your floor.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Nur Khamisa. First of all, I would like to express my deepest gratitude to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala has been giving us health condition and spare time till we can attend in this program, in this live, by saying Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Sorry. And secondly, a thank to our lecturer to give this chance to me to talk in this live. And the last, I thank to you all, the audience here. Thanks for your time and for minimizing the time just directly. Now, we will talk about talk a little about what floods are, the causes and the effect of floods, their impact and their prevention, and the current of flood disaster. We know that a flood is a natural event where an area or land that is usually dry become submerged in water. Simply stated, flooding can be defined as a flood of large amounts of water to land, which is usually dry. Floods occur because of many things, such as excessive rain, overflowing rivers, streams, lakes, or oceans. Floods are very dangerous and have the potential to wipe out entire city, coastline, or area and cause extensive damage to life and property. Floods also have a large erosive power and can be very damaging. And the next, as we know, water always flows naturally from high to low. This means that in the lowlands, flooding can occur more quietly before reaching higher ground. And floods can occur suddenly and reset quietly, but some things happen for days or even longer. So what causes flooding? When floods occur in area inhabited by human, water carries objects such as house, bridge, car, furniture, and even people. The power of floods can damage agricultural, directories, or heavy objects. The occurrence of flooding is caused by several factors. The following causes. Floods are, for the first is rain, the second is river overflow, the third is storm and strong wind on the beach, the fourth is dam is damaged, and the last is blockage of drainage. And the next is impact of flooding. What is the impact of flooding? The occurrence of floods has consequences that affect the economy, the environment, the human, and also the animals. And for the next, what the losses do to flooding? Flood disaster cause losses both morally and materially. Quote from the flood and fire classic disaster in the big city by Sri Purnayanti. Here are some loss caused by floods. The first is death. The second is damage to public facilities and infrastructure. The third is material loss. The fourth is outbreak of infection disease. The fifth is hamper transportation flow, and the last is hamper economic activity. So, are there any positive impact of flooding? The answer is yes. Yes, there is the positive impact of flooding. Although floods cause a lot of harm to human life, there are positive impact of flooding, especially when it occurs on flood plains and agricultural fields. Flood water carries a lot of nutrients stored in the plants. This nutrition land is considered perfect for farming. And as we already know that some regions are currently experiencing natural disaster, namely flooding. Floods hit the district of Wajo, Luwu or Masamba, Morowali, and also Sorong City. And the most suffer at this time, we know that North Luwu or Masamba. Yes, a few days ago, recently on Monday night, the Masamba area of North Luwu Regency, Sulawesi, was hit by flash flood that caused dozens of people to die. This flood even also caused around 15,000 local residents to evacuate based on preliminary data from the Operation Control Center of the Nation Disaster Management Agency, and or we can say BNPB. There are around 4,000 families affected by this flood. There are several causes of the Masamba flood that are currently predicted by experts. Some of this prediction include that the cause of lodging in the upper reaches of the river. Strong evidence of lodging in the mountain forest upstream of the river can be seen from the pitches of wood carried by water at the marsh of Shuhada. The cut is very neat. That is, it is the result of lodging using sensor. Sensor, you know sensor, right? Alat pemotong kayu. Meanwhile, head of the Social Protection and Social Security Division of the North Luwu Social Office, Sulfahardi, said that much of the forest in the upper reaches of Masamba and Rada rivers were already deforested. Many of mountains in the upper reaches of Masamba River had collapsed. There are dozens of landslide points. This landslide material that was washed away along with the flood and fill up the road in Masamba. Landslide also in the Meli mountains, which are upstream of the Rada River. One point landslide, but it's very long from the top of mountain to the foot of mountain. And so with this disaster, we can look at how the impact of illegal lodging, the impact of deforestation and upstream of the river. Therefore, let us together protect our environment starting from planting trees, not cutting trees carelessly, and also do not litter. And for the last, for all those affected by this disaster, keep your spirit up, because we will all help. You are great people, so excited and be patient. Okay, maybe that's all from me. If I have mistake, I do your apologize. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, it was the performance from Nur Kamisa. Now we would like to invite Asmila Mustafa. Please get ready. Okay, all while preparing, we move to the next queue. Muhammad Asrullah Arifin, are you ready? Muhammad Asrullah Arifin, are you ready? Oke.
Okay. Oke. Okay. Ya, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam.
The honorable our lecturer in public speaking, and then their audience member who are watching this hour performance. Okay. For the first time, let me say thank you for Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala because we can meet in here in our performance in public speaking. And then my name is Muhammad Asrullah Arifin. I'm from I'm the 8th semester of English department. Okay? In here I will explain about my title Be Yourself and Upgrading our quality. Being different from the others is arguably more striking than the others. What I mean in here, different is psychically and thoughtfully. Well, my friends and who know me personally understand the nature of my madness and often seen. Friends who know me, my nature is humorous and cheerful and often sulking. Sulking in here is ngambek mojo, but in my friendship, sulking is usually because if I not sulking with my friends, that's not have spicy in our friendship. Jadi di sini adalah sulking itu ngambek itu hanya sebagai bumbu-bumbu pertemanan kita. Jadi for our friends and my our and who know me, that's enjoy with our attitude. Okay, and then actually I was not like my friends you know. So, but I was introvert. An insecure person. As time as when by I keep thinking that I had to get out of my comfort zone to find a new comfort zone to better life. Several times I felt bullying, and often not considered by some people because my appearance was arguably unsightly. But I tried to ignore it and still tried to get better, even though I was still very, very insecure. I really want to be told I was still very insecure, and thus, who knows me, because doing good is pleasure for me, and I'm sure I will definitely come back to myself. Since I intend to become better, and I began to explore the world of photography, videography, and cinematic wedding, I also selling a seller online. And then I have some experience in the traveling world. I become a guide, and then several others business. But I'm still a very difficult several others. I'm still very difficult to believe in myself because I feel insecure, and yes, we must upgrade ourselves to better life, to prove our quality. Okay, this is I will promo my drink company, contemporary drink. This is a Creekmo. Now I'm as owner of the Creekmo contemporary drink, and God willing, inshallah, have many branch in Indonesia. My shop now in Talasalapang Street, and I will wait you all in my shop, Creekmo shop, and enjoy the promos. And then I have a Claude T. Bissell said, "Bricks more than other thing is have. Care more than other thing is wise. Dream more than other things is practical. Expect more than other thing is possible." And now conclusion is, what I bring to be yourself and keep upgrading yourself and be praising in something that is good for yourself and the people around you. Be aware of your best strengths, talent, interests, and don't be attempt to take care of the strength and strength others. Focus on your energy on becoming the best in your field. Search for interest and do the things you love with sincerity, and keep learning. If you need to ask the opinions of the people close to you, because maybe they, you know, the power that you might not realize. And then the last, never forget God in your way. Thank you very much. That's from me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Wow, interesting. Okay, thank you, Muhammad Asrullah. Next,
sir,
public speaker is Sri Wahyuni, right? Sri Wahyuni.
Sir, how about me? Can I?
Okay, Sri Wahyuni Ningsi. Sri Wahyuni Ningsi. Time's yours.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. Before I start to talking about our material, I would like to say thanks to our God, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, who has given us some mercies and blessing today. Secondly, may pleasure and salutation always deliver to our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And then also thanks to our lecturer who has given us this opportunity. Well, in this opportunity, I would like to talk about bullying and its bad sides. I believe that all of us must be really familiar with this word because we can see many cases about this on television and also read the case in news on our smartphone. Well, bullying itself is an action or behavior that carried out by someone or a group of people to hurt others in physical, verbal, or emotional form. The purpose of this action is to make the victim suffer and also to make the victim have psychological pressure. Broadly speaking, this bullying can be categorized into some forms. The first one is physical. This form certainly involves physical contact like hitting, pushing, kicking, and other damage things. The second is verbal bullying. This is probably most of the common forms of bullying that we can encounter in everyday life. It could be like insulting, ridiculing, or any sentences that committed to bullying others. And the third is social bullying. Well, before I continue my explanation, I have a question for you guys. Do you guys like to gossip or talking about the others behind them? If that's so, you need to stop that habits right now, because by spreading the bad news about a group of people, you have indirectly committed social bullying. By spreading the bad news about someone, you contribute to reducing that person's picture in the public. The next form of bullying is cyberbullying. The cyberbullying is behavior of bullying that carry out through the internet, such as through WhatsApp, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and other media. Bullying is not just happen accidentally. There are some types, there are some points that can cause this thing happens. The first is have personal problem. One of the reasons why people bullying the others is because they have a personal problem and they cannot solve it properly. So they feel like they're helpless. So it can be eventually become a trigger to make someone bullying the other. The second is revenge. Another reason why people bullying the other is because maybe in the past they were a victim of bullying itself. The next is envy. Envy can be another reason why people bullying the others, because for example, there was someone who doesn't like us, so he will spread the bad news about us, so we have a black bad figure in the public. The last is looking for attention. There are also some people who bullying the other just for to get attention from the other. If you meet this type of bullying, I can suggest you just ignore it. You're just leaving it alone, because when you doesn't care about them, when you leave it alone, they probably leave you too. Well, this bullying occurs with not without any impact. So we need to be aware of this. The impact of the bullying is not just happen for the victim, but also for the perpetrator and also for the bystanders. Well, firstly, we will talk about the impact of the bullying itself for the victims. There are some impact that happens in the victim. The victim of the bullying can also experience the negative effect, just like their mental, their psychology, and their health. For their mental, it can be like depression, anxiety, increased feeling of sadness and loneliness, and also
your voice, Sri Wahyuning.
They
your
will
voice.
Get. Okay. The next impact for the victim is decreased academic achievement and also in school participation. The next impact is about the preparators of the bullying itself. It can be like when they grow up in the future, they will be use alcohol, there will be drop out from the school if they are a student, and also they will get injected in early sexual activity. And also for the bystanders, it has also the impact of this bullying itself. The impact is it can be like increased use of tobacco, alcohol, or like bad things like using drugs and others. The next is they can increase mental health problem because they saw the bullying itself happen, so it can be increased their mental problem. Well, that's all about me. Thank you very much for your nice attention.
Thank you so much, Sri Wahyuningsih Muhammad, for yes, your sir. Performance. Okay, next, we'd like to invite Asmila Mustafa. That's yours.
Yes, sir. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Asmila Mustafa, and today I will present about the millennials' viewpoints related to marriage. As we see in the era now, there are many early marriage that occur either because of arranged marriage or so on. But what make me want to take this because there are some people who are not to consent with marriage. They are just busy with their career. Most of millennials are delay their plan to get married. This thing is related to their characteristic that doesn't like to have a commitment. They more focused to their career that can fulfill their basic character instead of being measured by the rules of getting married that make them lose their freedom. And besides that, there are several reasons why most of millennials do not marry early, such as on enough capacity in terms of financial, haven't met the right person due to more focus to their career that make them considering their age that too young to build their own family. Okay, due to development era, millennials count that merit only as a choice of life, not as necessity. Millennials are nowadays also like a really helpful by the technology. That's why happiness is not simply get by a marriage life, but can be got by another factors that support by the technology. Tanggapan saya terhadap konten ini bahwa tidak semua orang menganggap bahwa pernikahan itu adalah kebutuhannya. Di sini konten ini membahas bahwa mereka menganggap bahwa pernikahan ini bukan sebuah kebutuhan. Di sini juga membahas bahwa pernikahan itu sebenarnya bukan sebuah kebutuhan untuk hal membahagiakan. Ketika kayak dia ingin bahagia, maka dia beranggapan bahwa dengan teknologi mereka akan hidup bahagia. Oke. I think enough, sir.
All right, thank you, Hasmila Mustafa. Yep.
Yes, sir.
And next, where is Ardiansha? Ardiansha, get ready.
Inshallah, sir.
Okay. Hold on.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks for the opportunity to give it to me. Today, I will tell you something important for us to how your life be better than now. It's about the self-belief. Okay. You know, every single dream, vision, or idea in your life is start with a simple understanding that the obtainable that you can make it real. That's the beginning of everything. Self-belief is the gatekeeper that stands between current and future. See, if you think of reality is as the city walls you're living in, it's not crazy to think that they're within the walls. People that only use is only the life is only self-belief. In confidence is something greeted outside. Those walls that open the gate, they expand your reality. And if you don't believe anything good exists on the other side, why begin? If you don't think you're capable of getting there, why start? And this formula is simple, right? Let's not overthinking. We only move toward outcomes that we believe to be possible, and that's more important than ability, skill set, strength, I mean, you name it. Believing in yourself trumps all that, because the person with the inferior skill may be an effective natural talent, but they believe in something and they move towards it and give everything to this idea. They know it to be true. That's procrastinate. The one foot in and one foot out. And if you don't believe yourself, you're building a city of ascent. So please, guys, stop feeling insecure with yourself. Just believe yourself, because I believe everyone who born in this world is a winner, including you. So stop feeling insecure with yourself. Start believe yourself. Why self-belief? Because when you trying to reach your dreams and you have trouble, you will find the way to fix it. You never give up, you never stop, because you believe yourself, you will doing that. That's the power of belief. And guys, how to be better now? Don't allow yourself to be controlled by these five things: your past, other people's opinions, limited belief, relationship, and money. Just believe yourself. You can do anything. You can destroy all the walls that block in your path to reach your success. Because no, the winner in this world that can believe itself. If you want to change your life, the first thing you do is believe yourself. Remember, believe yourself is the key to be a winner in your life, because in your life, you're the main character, not other. So stop to fear a mistake, start to compare yourself with the other, and stop stuck in your past. Just take the first step to reach your dreams. Just believe yourself. Just believe yourself. Thank you. I think enough.
Okay, self-belief from Hardiansyah. Thank you so much. Okay, get ready. Who is the next? The next is Ahmad Ainul Hilmi. Okay. Get ready. Okay, that's yours. Ainul, you ready,
sir? Yes. Okay.
Noise.
Yes. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Our beloved prophet, peace be upon him, he said, glorious teaching us, he said, knowledge is like a camel. If you don't tie it, it will get lost in the desert. This statement is explained in other hadith of Abu Dawud. Tie knowledge by writing it down. For me, life is a vacation, and writing is my vacation from the living. Now I'm going to talk about the advantage of writing. One of the popular hobby, writing is an exploration. You can write everything, all about your knowledge, life, feel, or imagination maybe. You can know that writing is so important. And now I will explain about the advantage of writing. And then why that is so important for knowledge. First, what is the advantage of writing? As long as we know, writing is main advantage, but I will tell you about two advantage. First, writing can decrease your stress. Based on the statement of Jens Pennebaker, he's professor of psychology at the University of Texas. He said that. So if you have any problem that are unspoken, writing can help you to say your unspoken problem. Second, increase your creativity. By writing, your creativity will increase automatically. You can grow up your imagination by word. Just write whatever you comes into your head, and your mind will redirecting you to make writings. You can try that in everywhere. And that is the advantage of writing. And next, let me describe why writing is so important for knowledge. Like as my speech before, tell knowledge by writing it down. You have to remember your knowledge is your jariah. And in conclusion is, writing is exploration. You can get minimal to advantage by writing. Your stress will decrease and your creativity will increase. You have been known that knowledge is so important and everyone's right. So don't hold them. I suggest you let's share our knowledge. Think an easy way to do that is writing. And let's enjoy writing. And okay, that's enough for me. Thanks for attention.
Okay, thank you, Muhammad Ainul Hilmi.
Yes.
Okay. Now, we're waiting for Rosmala Dewi, but she's not here. So we move to Siti Hardianti Nasir. Are you here? Siti Hardianti Nasir. Get ready.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Siti Hardianti. Nasir, can call me Dayan. Now I experience. I have a question for those of you who are in this room. Do you love your mother? Do you love your father?
Yes, of course.
I believe I'm as a learner. I'm as a learner believe a 3 point that I always remember when I discovering something new. The first, the way you learn. And the second is effort. And the third is your attention. The first one, what does it mean about the way you learn? The way you learn, it determines the result that will come true. We know, we have a know well that we are as an English learner. When I was senior high school, my teacher asked me, why when you are in my class, you are my active student, but why when I give you an oral examination, an oral exam, oral test, you are always get 0 or 2 point or 3 point. And I always think every night, every day, what's going on me? And I always think about all the day. I think all my problem in the learning. And one day I realized my mistake. What I realized is the way of learning, the way I study English. I know I am as an English learner. I know the way I learn English exactly in English because I'm English department. The way I learning like I memorize new vocabulary in a day. For example, I memorize a new vocabulary, 10 vocabularies in a day. But why I always remember? But why when I come to the class, I always got 0, 2, or 5 points. I never get 10 or 9 points. And I changed the way I learned. I changed the way I learned, like memorizing. I really didn't understand what's going on me. And the second point when I learning, discovering something new, like when I speak, for example, I memorize 10 vocabularies in a day, but I never use it in speaking. So that way I face many difficulties in speaking or like answering my teacher question. And the second point is your effort. Let's move to my second point, like my effort. We are as an English learner, you have to pay attention more about our effort. Do we love our parents as a learner? So if you guys love your parents and you approve to your parents that I can do the best for you. I can proud of you. And my effort, when I was a third semester in a college university, I found many difficulty. I didn't know anything about English, but I always think that how could I take English department, but when I was a senior high school, even I didn't know about English. And finally, I realized the way I have changed my my learning way and the effort. Why? This is my third point, and my second point is related. It's one of part that can bisa dipisahkan, like my intention. When you are learn something new, but you don't have intention, For example, when you memorize a new vocabulary, or you want to get a 10 point or your best point in the school, but you don't have any attention, you also have effort, and but you don't have attention, how could you get a 10 point in the class? So that the three point that I always believe in myself, like the way you learn, the effort and your attention before you discover something new. So what's the main point from this story, from my statement, is do what you love and love what you do. Okay guys, thank you. I'm Diane. That's all from me. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Next, Andi Pirhamsyah, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Wow.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Okay, let me start. Can you? Yes, your microphone, please.
Cek ada suara aku, Sir.
Ya. But
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum.
Women to be thoughtful and merciful God, simply as well as desire, that accept His assistance and mercy to those who obey Him, that punish those who obey Him. Ladies and also gentlemen, that I appreciate. Indonesia, it's a large country, which is a pocket of hundreds of million people, with numerous islands spread extensively. We have been independent since 1945. Yet, component of individuals believe Indonesia needs to end up being independent in regards to education and learning yet. Despite the fact that we have actually altered its educational program almost annually, yet it appears that education and learning in Indonesia has actually not had the capacity to complete in its totality with the established country. We have the tendency to be left alone, have actually not been able to publish human resource premium quality of industrialist nation. Ladies and gentlemen, I follow. I am in to draw the line to the root, as well as I get the paradox that is discouraging in a country that is extremely plentiful. There are still several trains give up, wallet have no ethers, and swim to get to the college, given that the bridge is harmed. It is a paradox in the center of the world of our country. A kid that is not acquiring an education and learning, certainly they will definitely have trouble in accomplishing a better standard of living in the future. You have in effect observed that a great deal of poverty happens from ignorance, therefore much crime creating from destitution. Education is a substantial technique
to much better country to release top-notch employees. Eliminate distribution, absence of knowledge, and also squishing. Trains and trainers have diligence manners and also maintain attempt without relentlessness. We are a rich country. Indonesia is planned to have the most effective education. Do not stop on the path of our nation today, as well as continue to defend liberty of education. So simply, what's happening with our education and learning and knowing? The degree of education and also finding outcomes on point just education and learning as well as knowing is depending upon us. Good or poor education and learning of country rely on the progress. If we want to change our design of education, I will start by altering the method of viewpoint. To the very same education and also learning, keep attempting, keep discovering, maintain growth, maintain the production for our education and learning as well as knowing. Little mistake today, just few words on top edit I can use you today. I think just that, forgive me for my mistake as well. I assert. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Andi Pirhamsyah. Wait, it's about you have talked about education in Indonesia. Okay. Now we would like to invite Nur Amalia, ya. Nur Amalia.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, get ready. Time's yours.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Before I begin to deliver this speech, I would like to invite you to thank to Allah, the Almighty, who has given us mercy and blessing so we can meet together in this place, and also let's deliver salawat and salam to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has brought us from the darkness and the brightness. Today I will give a little information about the coronavirus or COVID-19, which for several months has continued to be a worldwide conversation. COVID-19 is a disease caused by super acute respiratory coronavirus, or COVID-19 can cause respiratory system disorders, varying from mild symptoms such as a flu to lung infection, such as pneumonia. COVID-19 is a new type of disease caused by a virus from the coronavirus group, namely such a COVID-2, which is also often called the coronavirus. The first case of this disease occurred in the city of Wuhan, China, at the end of December. After that, COVID-19 transmit between humans very quickly and spread to dozens of countries, including Indonesia, in just a few months. Its rapid spread makes some countries implement policies to impose lockdowns to prevent the spread of coronavirus. In Indonesia, the government implemented large-scale social restriction, or PSBB, policy to reduce the spread of this virus. COVID-19 was originally transmitted from animals to humans. After that, it was learned that this infection could also be transmitted from human to human. Transmission can be through the following methods: accidentally inhale saliva, splashes that come out when COVID-19 sufferers sneeze or cough, and hold the mouth, nose, or eyes without washing hands first after touching an object affected by a COVID-19 close contact. Please, there are factor for COVID-19. COVID-19 can infect anyone, but the effect will be more dangerous or even fatal if it affect the elderly, pregnant women, smokers, suppressed of certain disease, and people whose immune system are weak, such as cancer, suppressed, because it is easily transmit. The disease is also at high risk of infecting medical personnel who care for COVID-19 patients. Therefore, medical personnel and people who make contact with COVID-19 patient need to use personal protective equipment or APD. Symptoms of COVID-19. Early symptoms of COVID-19 infection can resemble flu symptoms, namely fever, runny nose, dry cough, sore throat, and headache. After that, the symptoms can disappear and heal or even aggravate. Patients with severe symptoms can experience a high fever, with a problem or bleeding, shortness of breath, and chest pain. The symptoms above appear with the body which again the COVID-19 virus. In general, there are three general symptoms that can indicate someone is infected with COVID-19, namely. The first, fever, dry cough, hard to breathe. In addition to the above symptoms, there are several other symptoms that are but can also appear in COVID-19 infections, namely easily tired, muscle ache, chest pain, sore throat, headache, nose, and diarrhea. Symptoms of COVID-19 can appear with 2 days, 2 weeks after person is infected with the virus that causes it. And some surprises, COVID-19 can cause any symptoms at all. However, these surprises or people without symptoms or OTG can still transmit COVID-19 to others. Okay, maybe that's all for me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
All right, Nur Amalia, talk about COVID-19, okay? Now, Andi Rahmawati.
Yes, sir.
That's your turn.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Andi Rahmawati, and I will experience about cosmetic surgery risks. So as we know, people are familiar with the term plastic surgery. Most of this is done to either beautify or repair parts of the body that they perceive to be defective or undesirable. A person who has undergone plastic surgery tends to do so again to repair another part of the body because they already have mindsets beauty is pain. The negative effect that comes from performing plastic surgery is, the first is adverse effect on health. So plastic surgery does not generally pose a major health risk. The most common complaints reported so far are headaches, nausea, vomiting, and persistent lameness that some experience following operation procedures. Most of these matter anyway, passes over time in inflammation around the area where the procedure is performed is another matter related to plastic surgery. And the second is a psychological impact. So patients who choose plastic surgery, especially cosmetic surgery, shall be kindly aware that the result they get may differ from what they expect before they go to the surgeon. Sometimes these procedures can leave scars that may not go away over time. It can have a lasting psychological effect on patients, dropping them into depression. It has been observed that many patients who undergo plastic surgery tend to become obsessed with their appearance. This can lead to addiction and can encourage them to undergo plastic surgery several times. A typical psychological disorder, this case is known as body dysmorphic disorder, where people develop a distorted and bizarre perception on their bodies that they cannot be satisfied with any appearance, and that there is current risk of surgery. So plastic surgery involves several surgical risks such as infections and allergic reactions, which are generally associated with any type of operations. In addition, drug reactions, excessive bleeding, denial of implants, pigmentation, blood clotting, skin necrosis, and scar tissue and nerve damage to specific areas. This process can add to smokers' risk as they tend to encounter delayed healing problems, increased risk of infections, breathing and lung problems. So people with certain vascular conditions can also experience lateness in the healing process. In rare addition, there are various risks associated with the use of anesthesia, such as allergy reaction, respiratory failure, and in rare cases, cardiac arrest and seizure. And the last is cost. So plastic surgery is a highly expensive procedure which involves skin grafts. This can put tremendous financial pressure on you and your family. While waiting, the cost of this operations, people tend to take into account the cost of surgery and completely ignore the unpredictable cost that can result from post-operative complication and hospital costs that must be expended if they have to remain in the hospital for post-operating procedures. So it's all for me, just for me. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay. Thank you so much for your presentation. Now, we would like to invite Santiani. Are you here, Santiani? Okay. Okay. She's not here. Okay. Now, we move to the next public speaker, Miss Wana. Are you ready, Miss Wana? Okay, that's yours.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Hello, everybody. Let me introduce myself. My name is Miss Wana. I am from Enrekang, and I am a student of University Muhammadiyah of Makassar. And now, I want to talk about smoking in public. As we know that in this era, there are many people like smoking, but before smoking, there are not looks many people there. And there are not things before that many people don't like smoke. For me, I don't like smoke because I have a history of asthma. And then when we always breathe cigarette smoke, it's not good for our health, and it makes our sick. I ever asked from my friends, why you very like smoking? And he answered that, I don't know, but when I am smoking, it makes my feeling good. And I asked him again, do you know that this make this can make you sick. And he answered that, I know, but I can't stop it. I think that is very worrying. Ladies and gentlemen, all certainly know smoking is a bad habit for our health. For the smokers and those around him. That is why there are the name of active smokers and passive smokers. Active smokers are people who smoke, and passive smokers and others not smoking, but they are the breeder the cigarette smoking for others. When someone smokes, most of the so that the smoke can, although not directly smoking, passive smokers can also be affected by the bad effect as well. The more frequent exposure to cigarette smoke, the higher the risk of health problems that may be experienced by passive smokers. So please don't smoking in public area. Even the public area have written bans not to smoking, but some people do not obey the restriction. They are only concerned with themselves without thinking about other people. They lost the awareness that the cigarette smoke that they spread in public area could cause illness for others, especially for babies and toddlers. For you who like smoking, please don't do that in public area, because you can be the cause them to become sick. For my ladies, when your boyfriend likes smoking, please leave him. He just doesn't love himself, let alone you. I think enough for this time. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Oke. Now get ready. Oke, okay, Ayu Chandrayani is here now.
Yes, sir.
Oke. Okay. Let's start.
Okay, thanks for the chance has given to me. My name is Ayu Chandrayani from 6C class. Okay, first of all, respect to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, our Lord of the world, and don't forget to say salawat and salam to our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Okay, now I will talk about woman emancipation. As we know, women often become the object of discrimination treatment because of the difference of condition and position between women and men, in which women are considered as a weak and men as a strong. This happened since long time ago and become a pattern of discrimination in the culture and society or in the family. Our woman emancipation hero, Raden Ajeng Kartini, said, Raden Ajeng Kartini said that women must be educated so that women can work and make okay, sorry, sir. Our woman emancipation hero, Raden Ajeng Kartini, said that women must be educated so that women can work and make money by herself. She can develop all of her ability and she will not be able to depend on other people. Remember that situation at the time when tradition was still stiff and Raden Ajeng Kartini surrounding. It saw how advanced and progressive her thought was. Moreover, now we live in the modern era, This is time for us to change the pattern of thought, which consider that women who study until high study still in the at least she only works in the kitchen. So the first thing that we have to stop in the discrimination, gender action. Don't see women as a weak figure and they don't have right and good quality of work compared to men. Okay guys, it is some as the gender discrimination that trafficking case now often happen the woman. Why? Because women are considered as weak, easy to trick and low educate. This is what we have to solve through education. Even though various programs have been done and applied to solve trafficking problems by government, but the result not really significant and maximum yet. The cause is the lack of awareness and knowledge of the victim. If all of Indonesian women have chance to have high education and they get direction, they will be able to reverse and defeat the act of discrimination and trafficking. Now is the time for the woman be smart, how to trick and not to accept something without thinking and knowing the truth. Okay guys, it is the most important to remember the fairness and gender is not only discussing about position and relation of woman with the community, but it has also been one step forward to build various ways and actions. We have to realize that incorrect the fairness should be started by building the capacity of women, making organization which can be a place to learn and also opening the access of learning. Okay, the last I will say, the emancipation will grow itself as the woman case the good quality. Now, I am as an Indonesian woman have to show our creation and case quality as a great woman. Woman with power and quality automatically can prevent the act of discrimination and trafficking will hit herself. For all Indonesian women, let's build our country by upgrading ourselves for be the better generation and the better nation. Okay, thank you, sir. I think enough. That's all from me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ayu Chandrani, talk about,
yes, sir.
Yeah, I talk about women emancipation, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Okay, interesting. Thank you so much. Now I'd like to invite Ade, the next public speaker. Where are you? Ade Rizky Amelia, are you here? Or if you're not here, let's invite Munawarah. Munawarah? Okay, Munawarah, are you ready? Can you unmute your computer? We can't hear you here. No.
Baik di sarangku, sir.
Okay, can you start?
Okay, can you start?
Oh, okay, sir. Yeah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Munawarah. My material is about smoking public. Why I choose smoking public for my material? Because because I'm sometimes annoyed for I'm something annoyed looking public for my.
Sorry, Munawara, can you fix your microphone over there?
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Why I choose smoking public for my material? Because I'm sometimes annoyed about smoking in public, especially when we hang out in public place. It is disrupt me, and I don't like a cigarette smoke. Okay. We are not familiar with the name of cigarette, not only among young people and even children are not all enough to be active smokers. Active smokers are smokers who smoke or cigarette users, and passive smokers are people who do not smoke but inhale cigarette smoke from active smokers. Many smokers who usually smoke do not know the place. Some are in public fiki hall, some are in public place, and some are even while driving motor bikes. Lack of awareness and lack of strict regulation about no smoking area make there are still many people who smoke in public place. Do smokers never think of negative effect that happen if smoking in public place? For whatever reason, smoking in public place is certainly not justified in my mind, because smoking in public has a lot of effect besides being harmful to the health of smokers and those around them. Smoking in public also gives social damage to young people. Example, people who smoke in public place will be seen by others, especially children. This can make children tend to imitate smoking. Public smoking is not justified because cigarette smoke can be inhaled by anyone around us, and like parents, children, and pregnant women, and many others. As for the negative impact for health, like my experience as a passive smoker is to cause coughing, shortness of breath, to other respiratory disorders. There are many negative effects in the content of cigarette, such as tar. Inhale, tar will settle to the lungs. If we inhale the cigarette content, it causes too much lung disease like lung cancer, heart disease, and fertility disorders. And there are many ingredients in cigarette that are dangerous of cigarette. My message moral for smokers is that smokers should look at the situation and choose where to smoke and will not disrupt other people. Smoking is right everyone, but still with ethics. I think enough. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. You were talking about cigarette, yeah?
Yes, sir.
You have a message for the smoker.
Yes,
thank
sir.
You so much. Oh, now the next is Mul Heriadi. Are you here? Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Wait a minute. Okay, can start.
Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Mul Heriadi. I'm going to give a talk on drug use among teens. In my speech, I would like to share with you some cause of drug abuse among youth. Abuse among the teenager is one of the most important issue in our society today. The question that lingers is, why does this issue continue to disrupt generation after generation teen? The first is simple. Currently, many teens have heard about drugs and they are curious to experience them for themselves. They have heard the drugs on can be fun or make a person feel and act different. Maybe they have seen their friends or family members behave differently while on drugs, and they want to see how it really feels. We see drugs on TV and movie every day. Many young people encounter them at school, at home, or in the neighborhood. It is not unusual to be curious about something you see and hear about so often. So many people first trying drugs because they are curious about them. Another reason young people take drugs is depression. Maybe their home life is not very happy, maybe have a boring job, are not doing well in school, or are just not happy with their life for whatever reason. For many people, drugs are a way to escape the unhappy reality. They can feel a little braver, stronger, a little smarter, more beautiful, or more important. Of course, this doesn't last long, but doesn't matter for the brief time that the drugs are taking effect. The user can forget about the problem, responsible, and limitation of everyday life and escape to a fantasy world. It is no secret that drugs can change the way you feel. This is why they are so effective to young people despite their dangers. Besides, stress also is one of the main cause of drugs abuse among youth. When they are not drugs, well, it their examination or getting poor results. They may consume drugs. The issues of school bullying are also leading to the drugs taking between them. They try to forget the trauma of being bullying, so they use drugs. They cannot manage their stress as well, so they take drugs as the solution. In other hand, teenagers will low self-esteem, especially those are poor in social communication skill, are likely to engage in self-abuse behaviors, such as drug use. I have to stop here, and I hope you have found my talk helpful. That's all I can share with you, and thank you so much for lending your ear. And assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Mulheriadi. Yeah. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, now next is Samsul Rizwan.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Samsul Rizwan. Time's yours.
Okay, sir. Can I restart?
Yes, please start.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, thank you for the opportunity given to me. And in this occasion, I will talk about the importance of mental health awareness. As we know, from research conducted by expert mentioned there, mental illness affect 19% of the adult population and 46% of teenagers and 13% of children each year. People struggling with their mental health may be in your family, life next door, teach your children, and work in the next cubicle. However, only half of those affected received treatment, often because of the stigma attached to mental health. Untreated, mental illness can contribute to higher medical expenses, poor performance at school and work, fewer employment opportunities, and increased risk of the suicide. And next, what exactly is a mental illness? A mental illness is a physical illness of the brain, that causes disturbance in thinking, behavior, energy, or emotion that make it difficult to cope with the ordinary demands of life. Research is starting to uncover the complicated cause of this disease, which can include genetics, brain chemistry, brain structure, experiencing trauma, and or having another medical condition like heart disease. For this mental illness, there are two most common mental health conditions. And the first condition is anxiety disorders. More than 18% of adults each year struggle with some type of anxiety disorder, including post-traumatic stress disorder, obsessive compulsive disorder, panic disorders or panic attacks, and generalized anxiety disorder. And the second condition is mood disorder. Mood disorders such as depression, bipolar depression, affect nearly 10% of adults each year and are characterized by difficulty in regulating one mood. So what we can do to help this mental illness? Although the general perception of mental illness has improved over the past decades, studies show that stigma against mental illness is still powerful, largely due to media stereotypes and lack of education, and that people tend to attach negative stigmas to mental health conditions at a far higher rate than to other diseases and disabilities, such as cancer, diabetes, and heart disease. Stigma affects not only the number seeking treatment, but also the number of resources available for proper treatment. Stigma and misinformation can feel like overwhelming obstacle for someone who is struggling with a mental health condition. A few powerful things we can do to help, like first, showing individual respect and acceptance, like remove a significant barrier to successfully coping with their illness. Having people see you as an individual and not as your illness can make the biggest difference for someone who is struggling with their mental health. And the second thing, advocating within our circle or influence, is to help ensure that individuals have the same rights and opportunity as other members of your school and community. And the third and the last we can do to help the mental illness, learning more about mental health allow us to provide helpful support to those affected in our family or our community. I think that's all I can say about mental illness. Sorry if there is a shortage or mistake. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oh, waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. It was a great presentation from Samsul Rizwan. Thank you so much.
Yes, sir.
And now we'd like to invite Santiani, are you ready? Santiani or Andi Kamrayadi, are you here? Andi Multasham? No? No more students?